Now we go to KITV4's Lara Yamada at Joint Base Pearl Harbor Hickam for a very important departure.
So, Pamela, a very windy, blustery, and rainy night here tonight for the departure of the president and the first family. Fortunately, though, shortly before the president left, the rain at least stopped. Good news not only for them, but also for the folks that were waiting for him. About 50 people here, friends and family, we understand, of staff members and service members, very anxiously waiting to see the president and the first lady. But before the president arrived, the first dog, Bo, arrived. He was taken out for a quick pit stop by one of his handlers before he was one of the first to jump on board Air Force One. And not long after that, the president and the first lady arriving to that crowd of about 50 people waiting out the rain and wind out here. Very nice, though. They came forward slowly, working their way down the crowd of the people waiting. Plenty of people taking pictures, as you might imagine. We saw that there were a number of kids and babies in the family, making some moments for them and their family. The first lady following right behind the president, doing the same, working the crowd. Plenty of people taking pictures. Now, a bit of a broken-up trip for the first family and for the president, the first family arriving on December 22nd. The president, unfortunately, having to leave a few days after that because of everything that was going on in Washington, D.C. with the fiscal cliff. He was able to return for Senator Inouye's memorial on Christmas Eve. Very emotional and memorable day. The president deciding not to speak on that day. But again, having to return back to Washington, D.C. for about a week before he could return again and join his family for some, unfortunately, not the greatest weather the last few days he was here. But he managed to squeeze in some fun with the family, including some bowling and his annual trip to Island Snow to get some shave ice for the family. And we understand yesterday he had a round of golf that lasted about 5 hours, but again, not the greatest weather. In fact, if you might remember, that was the day that the PGA, for the first time in some 8 years or so, had to cancel scores for the players because the weather was so bad. The president and the first family getting a chance to get some good eats, Morimoto's earlier in their trip, and then to Buzz's Steakhouse, and also to Nobu's in Waikiki last night, where we understand he was there till about 12:30. Some crowds getting a chance to take off some pictures of the president out there as well. So on the last few hours that he was here, we understand that he just enjoyed some time in Kailua at the beach house and again getting some good eats over at Buzz's Steakhouse before he headed here to Hickam Air Force Base to join the crowds before he boarded Air Force One along with the family. Kind of a special moment because we got a chance to see what appeared to be two Air Forces One, essentially, because it was the backup plane that was also here. Typically not the case, usually more for international travel, but a special sight for the crowd that was here. Some of the folks that we talked to saying this is the first time they've had a chance to experience this, so a little added extra special touch for them. So the president and the first family are wrapping up their trip, heading back to Washington, D.C., and as you can imagine, it is going to be a very political season for the president, having to deal with the debt ceiling as well as a number of appointments. So we wish them well and safe travels, and that is going to be it for us here at Hickam Air Force Base. Pam, I'll go ahead and send it back to you.